Hi everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to achieve this result. It's a login landing page in which we have the two sides, basically this side more like a marketing side, and then the place where we need to insert our username. Here it is, my username, then the password, and then the user can click the login, or if it has already a login, it can register. So it's a responsive landing page. We can see it by reducing the size and try it with different devices. If I just unpin the developer tool, by clicking on this button, I can see how it behaves at different devices, like an iPhone X or a Galaxy, and we can see that it behaves properly for different screen sizes. So let's do it. I'm going to close it. Here it is, our repository. It's Visual Studio Code where we have already loaded our image. It's an image found on Unsplash. I'm going to create our index.html and then, leveraging Emmet that is already built in with Visual Studio Code, I can create my first index.html where I write responsive page and then I can start writing the application. So we will have two sections. A first section with a class side and the second section that is our main section. So I just added the class main. In the left side section, if you remember, we have a main message and a secondary message. So I insert a paragraph with the class main, let's say message, where I write digital products marketing. And then a second paragraph, but this time it's a secondary message. And here we are. I can write your perfect place to. I go to the next line by doing PR. Sorry for that. What's that? Okay. To buy and sell digital goods. Perfect. Now we can already see this first result. I have installed the plugin Live Server in order to see the result already on port automatically. It's 5500 or 5501. And here it is our application where we have our main message and secondary message. Good. Let's bring them like that. Then I can write our main section. Our main section will have basically just a paragraph for the title. So I add the class title where I tell the user that it has to proceed with the member login. And we see it appearing on our website. And then we have the form. Or the need in this case to put the action as we are dealing only with the front end in this case. Then we have some form control, each for every input we need to insert. So I have the class form control. And then we have our input. Its type is text where we insert the username. So I add a placeholder. Let me make it a bit bigger. A placeholder with written username. And then we will insert our border. We save it, it's there. We insert the space for the border because when the user focuses on the input, it will have the bottom border expanding. It's a nice little animation we're going to insert. So it's a div with the class focused border. And then we need to insert also the icon. For the icon, we are going to use Fontosum with these classes, FAS, FA user. I save it. And now we're going to import Fontosum. I'm using Cloudflare. Fontosum. I'm having network connections problems. Let me reconnect to the network. I'm connecting. Okay, perfect. I'm going to copy this one and to insert it here. It's a link pointing to the link that we already have already copied. Here we are. Perfect. Now If we look here, we see that the icon appeared. So we can now copy this section and paste it there for the password. Here, write password and then focus border. And we will have here FASFA unlock. Great. Here we are. And then in again in the form, we are going to insert the button with the class action where we tell the user to click it and proceed with the login. And at the end, but outside the form, we are going to insert the paragraph. I call it with the class register, where we ask him not an account, so you can register. And I insert the link for him to register. Save it. Just insert an href that points nowhere, basically to the same page. Here we are. So we have ended our HTML part. We have a left side, let's say, and the main side where the user can log in. And now we are going to insert the style. For the style, we are going to insert a new link to a local CSS style that I call it style.css, and then that I'm going to create now. So I go here, create new file, call it style.css, that is referenced into our index.html. So here I just do some reset of two or three styles, basically the margin, then the padding in order to overwrite the browser default options. I reset the margin, the padding, the box sizing, it's the best practice to set it to border box, and then we can insert the font family. Sorry, font family. I'm going to use Monserrat, it's a Google font, free font family that I'm going to download. Sorry, not to download, but to take the link for Google Fonts. Here we are. I write here Monserrat. Here it is. We click there. We select the regular, basically, select the style, and we can copy the link, Ctrl C. I go into our page and I paste it here. Here we are. I save this part, and then in our CSS, it tells us just to copy this font family Montserrat and the sans serif as a fallback. So I copy it here, and if I save it, we see that our font changed. Perfect, we can start styling properly our page. So, for the body, I selected to have a min 8 of 100 VH. Basically, the minimum 8 will be the whole page display grid. As I said, in our body, we have two main sections, the left one and the right one. So, I tell him to have a display grid. And then to have two columns, grid template columns, sorry. And we will have the first column that is 65% wide, and the second color that will take the rest of the space, 1FR. If we save it, we see already the two columns, one here and one there. Then I can just start styling the section, a general style that is okay for both sections, basically a bit of padding, 2.5 dm, then display flex in order to align the items inside each section. Now the display flex is a justify content. It means an horizontal alignment by default that is, it has a flex direction that is by default horizontally aligned. So we need to specify it to have a flex direction that is a column. Here we are, and we will have the items that are vertically aligned. And then we can specify them to be justified at the center, horizontally aligned at the center. Perfect. Here we are, vertically aligned at the center. Then we can start styling this part. This part, it's this section, basically, with the class side. So we start by setting the style here, side. We want it not to be vertically centered aligned, but to, sorry, vertically, yes, but horizontally, we want it to be in the center. So if I insert a background color gold, let's say, just to see it, we see that horizontally it's not centered aligned, but it's aligned to the left. So we want it to, it has already, this is a section, it has already a display flex. We want to add it to have an align items center in order for it to go to the center, because otherwise by default it's flex start. Perfect. Now we have a background. We want to introduce the image, so it's URL images, the image we have. Here it is. We just add a couple of properties, the no repeat to be sure there are no repetitions of the same image, and to center it in the center. Perfect. And now we can insert a little layer darker in order for our text to be seen better on it. So we can do it adding to our section a pseudo element, particularly the before pseudo element. The before pseudo element, as well as the after, actually only works if you specify the content. Okay, and now we can start filling it. So with positioning it absolute, top 0, left 0, with 100% and 8, 100%. Basically here with these four properties we are telling him take the whole space of your container. Actually, as it has a position absolute, it goes to the parent and so on until it finds an element with a position that is not static, basically. So we need to specify to its parent here a position relative, otherwise it will take all the body, it will go to the body. So okay, I wait to set that one in order to show you. So background color, I use the RGBA way to insert a dark layer. Basically this is the opacity. I introduced let's say a grayish layer, an opaque layer, and the opacity is 0.6. We see that it didn't stay only to its father element, but it took all the body, and it's because its father hadn't that position relative. Perfect. Now it takes only this one. Okay, perfect. Let's go and style this text. So, generally speaking, for both paragraph of this one, for these two, we have some common style that I'm going to insert, and it's the position relative. Okay, then the color, we want them to be white. Then the text align to the center. This property will be useful in small devices. We are not going to see it, but in small devices, yes. Then a bit of letter spacing. And then line 8 of 1.4 am. And finally, font size, a bigger font size of 1.7 rem. Rem is with respect to the root element, the body that by default is 16 pixels. Now we're going to style this one. And this one is side main message. Here we are. So first of all, transform to uppercase. Here we are. Then it's a bigger font size. Perfect. Here it is, quite big. Then bold. Its font weight, we set it to be bold. Cool. Then a minimum width in order to be sure to have maximum two words there. So, sorry, a max width of 550 pixels. And then a bit of margin at the bottom of 3 am. Perfect, this is styled. Let's go and finish the style there. Actually, for the moment, I'm leaving it like that. So basically, we have styled this part. I'm going to leave it like that. It's pretty okay. We go and style this side. Here we are. It's a section with the class main where we have a title, this title there, and then the form, this one. And then at the end, this paragraph to help the user register. So let's style the title. Give it a color like that. Here we are. Then a bigger font size of 2 rem. Then we converted it to uppercase. Uppercase, here we are. Then a font weight, a bold font weight. Bold, perfect. Then a bit of letter spacing, 0.4 pixels. And then a margin bottom of 2 mm. Here we are, we have done it. Let's start styling the form. As we said, the form, here we are, we have a form element and then the form control and the input inside the form control. Let's style it. So for the form, we only specify to take all the horizontal space. So with 100%, perfect. Then each, let's introduce common style for the input and the button. And speaking about these two inputs and this button, and the common style is to not have a border and also the outline, and to increase their font size. Here we are. So now let's style our input. Sorry, before the input, I forgot to style the form control. Here it is. In order it also to take the whole space, horizontally speaking. So I just add it here. Here we are in the form control. We have, we specify it to have a width of 100% and then a position relative. I will tell you later why I'm doing that. And then a bit of margin of, let's say 1.7 mm. Perfect. And then we can go and style our inputs. So the input also has to stretch horizontally. So with 100%, we can introduce it a border bottom of 1 pixel solid and a light gray like that. Then to color it, as we did before, here we are, then a bit of letter spacing, and finally a bit of padding. Here we are. So basically now we need to style these icons. So let me show you. We have the form control that basically it's what wraps the input, and we need to style the each icon with the position absolute there, basically, at the beginning and vertically centered. It's for this reason that I put a position relative to the form control, because this icon should be positioned absolute relative to its father, to the form control. So let's write the style for the icon. We are telling here, we go to the input and we take its I sibling. As I said, position absolute, then left just a bit 8 pixels, here we are. Then I need to position it vertically, and to position it vertically we can do it like that. We can position it top 50%, but then it's a bit down because it starts at 50% of the 8 and goes down, so we need to translate it up 50% of its height, and we do it like that. Transform, translate Y minus 50%. Now it's perfectly centered, aligned. And now we select the color. And finally, a bit of transition, because we are going, when the input is focused, to color it in a certain way. And we want to hit the icon to change the color smoothly. So we transition the color of 0.4 seconds. And now we are going to say input, when it is focused, we need to color its sibling like that. So it's 0E484B. Here we are. Now it's not working. Why? Focus. It's not focus, but it's focus. Here we are. So, when we have the input focus, its sibling will have this color, while before it had this color, and we transition it smoothly from this color to this one. Here we are. You can see the icon transitioning. Now we want the bottom border effect expanding. We are going to achieve that in this way. We inserted this element here with the class focused border. Here we are. So we say input, then we go and take its sibling with the class focused border, and then we say that the element will have a position absolute, then with, let's say for the moment 100%, 8 of 2 pixels, a bottom positioning 0, so we want it to be positioned there at the bottom, and then we need to color its background. Background color, and we can copy this color there. We could use also CSS variables in this case. So we see it. We see that it has a width of 100%, but we want it to expand when we focus on the button. So, sorry, on the input. So in this case, we want it to be 100%. So we can achieve it like that. We can copy this selector and add it a focus pseudo element. And then we can copy the width and telling it when you focus on the input, its sibling with that class will have a width of 100%. Here we are. But now we want it to smoothly increase its width, so we transition its property, its width property. Let me show you. Here we are. A very nice and smooth animation. Perfect. Now we have to style the login button. Here we are. It's this one, button with the class action. Perfect. I just added a background color. I copy it from there, save it. We style the background color, and now let's insert all the other styles. So color, let's give a white text. Perfect, a bit of padding. Great. Let's give him a bit of margin of 2 a.m. auto and 4 a.m. Perfect. So we want it to be distanciated 2 a.m. and 4 a.m. top and bottom. Then a border radius. Here it is. We want it to be uppercase. To have a letter spacing. To be bold, so font weight bold. And then now we see that the cursor is not a pointer, but we would like it to be transformed into a pointer to help the user understand that it has to click. So we can write cursor pointer. Here we are. And then we want also when the cursor hovers on it to something happening. We want something to happen. And we achieve that in this way. By telling him when the cursor hover over it, the opacity should go from 0 to 0.9, just slight. But we want it to be transitioned in order to pass from 1 to 0.9 smoothly. So, here it is. Perfect. Now we need to style this part, and then just very, very few styles for the responsivity, and we will see that the work will be done. So, let's style this part. We have a paragraph with a register class. Sorry, and the link here inside. Let me put it like that. And the link here with the written register. So, we go there. Register, we select the link there. We see that the link by default has some text decoration, so we need to specify that the text decoration, if I can spell it, decoration is none. Perfect. Then we can introduce a bit of margin, but to be affected margin on a link, the link needs to have its display property at least as an inline block. So display inline block. And then we can insert a margin left of 0.5 AM, then we color it of what was it? Here it is. Perfect. And then a bit of weight. Bold. Here we are. So we have achieved our page. Here it is. But now we can see that if I reduce the size, everything is messed up. So let's fix that. Let me take this one like that. Let me resize it. Perfect. Let me open the developer tools. There, like that. Sorry, I open it and I go outside from that side. So we can see here on the top left that when I move it, we see the pixels. This helps us understand when we need to introduce a breakpoint. And we do it with the media query. Media query. So the first breakpoint I would like to introduce is when the max width achieve 980 pixels. And there we need for the body to go and search the style that we had before. Here it is in the body. We had the two columns of 65% and 1FR. We need to reduce it. Perfect. And then we just need, I move it there, for these sections to reduce the padding a little bit, basically for this one. So I say section, I set it like that, padding left 1.5 dm, and the same padding right. Here we are. Now we see, if we open it again, we can see that while going down again, we need to add other breakpoints. So I copy this media query, I make a bit of space, I set another breakpoint at 800 pixels, I reduce, sorry, for the body, I reduce this one to 60 before, and now I reduce this one to 55. Perfect. And now this is okay for us. We just want to reduce the text size here, and we go and select it by saying side section and main message, a font size of 2.7 pm. Here we are. We reduce the text and now it seems okay. We copy it to introduce another breakpoint, because when we see it reducing, we see now we would like only to have in this side and to have this one disappear, because the screen starts to become too small. So I copy this one, I insert another breakpoint at 680 pixels, where I set the body no more with two columns, but with only one column. Here we are, but now we need to hide this one, and we can achieve it like that. So the side section, it is this one. We can just write display none. Here we are. And now the only thing we need to do is to center this text, this button, and this other text, and we can do it by setting the form as display flex and flex direction column flex direction column. This button has margin auto here and there, so we can already so it is already centered. And now what we need to do is to tell that the paragraphs will have a text align center. Perfect. Now I'm having the doubt whether I can comment this out. No, because of this one, so I just set it back. Here we are. So we arrived at the end of our video. We show a login landing page that is has a responsive behavior that behave well for different screen size, 8 and width. We could see also that for different devices the behavior is right. Here we are. I can write my user, my password, and the user see the effect on the login. Perfect. We arrived at the end of the video. If you like it, please like, subscribe the channel, and stay tuned. We will see in the next videos. Bye.